What's up, guys? In this video, let's go ahead and talk about what blockchain is and what are the things that are important that you need to know about blockchain. I'm not a professional advisor, but let's get it on. All right, so this is the website that I feel has the best definition on what blockchain is and what are the things that you need to know about blockchain. It is Investopedia, and the link to this will be in the description of the video. So first things first, guys, okay, what is blockchain? So blockchain is a distributed database or ledger that is shared among the nodes of a computer network. So as a database, a blockchain stores information electronically in digital format. So let me go ahead and zoom in a little bit on that one. That way you could go ahead and check that one out. And again, guys, link to this will be in the description of the video. So blockchains are the best known for their crucial role in cryptocurrency system, such as Bitcoin. And I'm sure if you are into cryptocurrency, there is no need to explain what Bitcoin is. So for maintaining a secure and decentralized record of transactions, the innovation with a blockchain is that it guarantees the fidelity and security of a record of data and generates trust without the need for a trusted third party. So basically, it is a network that is very secured. One key difference between a typical database and a blockchain is how the data is structured. A blockchain collects information together in groups known as blocks that hold set of information, and then the blocks have certain storage capacities and when filled are closed and linked to the previously filled block, forming a chain of data known as the blockchain. Now, all information or all the new information that follows that freshly added block is compiled into a newly formed block that will then also be added to the chain once filled. Now, that is what blockchain is, and you could read through the entire thing, but that basically the summary on what blockchain is. So the key takeaways, there you go. Blockchain is a type of shared database that differs from a typical database in the way that it stores information. Blockchain stores data in blocks that are linked together via cryptography. So how does a blockchain work? The goal of blockchain is to allow digital information to be recorded and distributed, but not edited, okay? So in this way, a blockchain is the foundation for immutable ledgers or records of transactions that cannot be altered, deleted, or destroyed. This is why blockchains are also known as a distributed ledger technology, or DLT. You might have encountered that in the future. If you see a DLT, you think blockchain. Okay, so first proposed as a research project in 1991, the blockchain concept predated its first widespread application in use, Bitcoin, in 2009. In the years since, the use of blockchain has exploded via the creation of various cryptocurrencies, decentralized finance, or DeFi, in other words, applications, non-fungible tokens, or NFTs, and smart contracts. So if you don't know those terms, guys, we created videos in our channel that would talk more in depth about what cryptocurrencies, what DeFi is, what non-fungible tokens or NFTs are, and what smart contracts are. So go ahead and check that one out. So transaction process, you have this process flow. Okay, so a new transaction is entered and then goes to the transaction that is transmitted to the network of peer-to-peer computers scattered across the world, and then goes to the network of computers, then solves equations to form the validity of the transaction. Once confirmed to be legitimate transactions, they are clustered together into blocks, and these blocks are then chained together, creating a long history of all transactions that are permanent. And then after that, the transaction is complete. So the attributes of cryptocurrency, you can go ahead and check that one out as well. Blockchain decentralization. Okay, so real quick on this one. So to validate new entries or records to a block, a majority of this decentralized network's computing power would need to agree to it. So to prevent bad actors from validating bad transactions or double spends, blockchains are secured by a consensus mechanism such as proof of work, or the POW, or proof of stake, which is the BOS. Okay, so these mechanisms allow for agreement even when no single node is in charge. And is blockchain secure? That's one question for you guys, I'm sure. Blockchain technology achieves decentralized security and trust in several ways. To begin with, new blocks are always stored linearly and chronologically. That is, they are always added to the end of the blockchain. So, due to the size of many cryptocurrency networks and how fast they are growing, the cost to pull off such a feat probably would be insurmountable. This would not be only extremely expensive, but also likely fruitless. Thus, such thing would not go unnoticed as network members would see such drastic alterations to the blockchain. The network members would then hard fork off to a new version of the blockchain that has not been affected. That would cause attack version of the token to plummet in a value and making the attack ultimately pointless. As the bad actor has no control over a worthless asset, the same would occur if the bad actor were to attack the new fork of Bitcoin. So it is built this way so that taking part in the network is far more economically incentivized than attacking it. So ultimately, yes, blockchain is secure. Now, next one, and this is basically, I also would like you to know, guys, Bitcoin versus blockchain. Is it different? Is it the same? Or is Bitcoin a blockchain or something like that? Oh, blockchain technology was first outlined in 1991 by Stuart Haber and W. Scott Sternetta, two researchers who wanted to implement a system where document timestamps could not be tampered with. But it wasn't until two decades later, with the launch of Bitcoin, okay, in January of 2009, that blockchain had its first real-world application. Bitcoin protocol is built on a blockchain. In a research paper introducing the digital currency, Bitcoin's pseudonymous creator, Satoshi Nakamoto, referred to it as a new electric cash system that's fully peer-to-peer with no trusted third party. That is the dawn of Bitcoin. Okay, next, blockchain versus banks, right? Blockchains have been heralded as being a disruptive force to the finance sector, and especially with the function of payments in banking. However, banks and decentralized blockchains are vastly different. Okay, so to see how a bank differs from blockchain, let's compare the banking system to Bitcoin's implementation of blockchain. Okay, so blockchains versus banks. So you have information in there as well, and you can go ahead and read through everything that you need to know about blockchain. This website says it all. Okay, so it has a very, very good explanation on what blockchain is, and I would highly recommend that you read through the entire thing and digest it. That way, when you encounter other information, like what are other cryptocurrencies, and then if it's blockchain, you already know what it is. All right, so if you're new to the channel, guys, please make sure to click that like, that subscribe, and click the bell. That way you'll always be notified when we upload new videos in the future. I will see you on the next. I'm out. Peace.